finally got a new module by Synth here, so I just wanted to play with it. So, a little Saturday afternoon. Saturday afternoon stream. Pretend like I haven't fed her. I kind of. How's that? Any better? Yeah? Thank you. about that. How are we sounding now? Got a new module. Got this camera. I figure like I can face this way and it doesn't look like I'm facing away from you guys as much. I got a randomizer module. I should read the instructions. How's you guys' weekend so far? Sometimes. Trying to do it. I'm thinking about maybe trying to do these kind of streams. been trying to do these streams a little more between the hours of like 11 and 1, you know. Better reaper module real bad. It just depend on if I'm free or not, you know. Cause moving it to earlier kinda just means more time to do other random shit. Not random shit, but I have a lot on my mind lately. Lagging? What kind of lagging? Like an audio thing, or? Look at my connection. I've got a stable connection. And when you say it's lagging, what do you, what do you mean exactly? Huh. Anybody else here able to say a similar thing? Yeah, no, just describe to me what you're seeing. Whirling circle death. Because depending on what you say, it might sound like it's your end. It's hard for me to know what you're... If I know what you're seeing, I can know what the problem is, you know what I mean? Yeah. Need a little more reverb on this thing, you know? Got a reverb module coming. A little bit of shimmer going, you know? Well, you don't have to be sorry. You're good. You're good. I'm trying to be the guy whose stream isn't always fucking up, you know? Back to reading this manual real quick. How's your weekend? How's your weekend going? I'm sorry, I got a new module, so I gotta kind of read about it for a minute. Great knob. Slow to fast. Researching and testing? When are you researching and testing? When clocked, rate will control the rhythmic probability of the random gates. Knob is far left. The big values for random gate will be limited to eighth notes. The knob's turned right. Rhythmic possibilities for gate will increase and begin to include smaller, larger, triplet derivatives of the incoming clock. When knob is far right, each incoming clock builds, causes nano range between all rhythmic values. Oh, cool. Right on. You're an engineer, I assume? Presume? Switches the internal clock between high range and low range. Range is high when it's low. Okay. Computer toucher. Love it. We love computer touching. Just my random book, therefore. What the best way to do it? I got something called the qubit nanorand. Just some randomization into things. I might get rid of. I have a qubit octone that kind of does a little bit of randomization stuff, but something about it doesn't seem to be working. I got this, and I might if this is better, I might get rid of that. Cool. I've also got a couple other Qubit things coming. I like Qubit. This is the module company. Really cool stuff. Okay, so when it's this color, I don't know if you can even see it, let me. The knob right here, purple right now, and then you can change it from purple to a blue, to an orange, green, and then it'll do different randomization patterns. When it's purple, then when it's purple, be random stepped voltages. It'll just be kind of just random voltage numbers coming out. When it's blue, it'll be LFO waveforms. So I should try to throw that into here. Yeah, okay, we're getting someone turning this knob over and over again. Like a crazy person. Yeah. There's a switch here. It says unipolarity and bipolarity. Switches random voltage output between unipolar positive, bipolar polarity. Unipolar positive random voltage range between 0 and 5. Bipolar random voltage range is plus minus 8. Cool. So I might want to try that, actually. For the clock. Right. Internal external switch. Gate out when internally locked. Gate out produces periodic gate signals at the rate of the internal clock. When externally clocked, gate out produces random gate signals that are derived from external clock source. On each incoming clock, Anaran calculates a musical derivative of the incoming clock rate and outputs a random gate signal at that frequency. A new rhythmic value is randomly chosen each time clock receives a gate. Okay. That's kind of wild. Actually, okay. I know what I want to do with that. I have a different clock source here. And then I'm gonna put the random gate out. Throw it up here. Hey Totoro, how are you? Doing good. I just got a new module here. Got like a randomization module, the qubit nano rando. Playing around with it. I don't normally stream Saturday in the early afternoons, so, you know, kind of trying this out. I like it. Might start streaming a little earlier in the day, as opposed to in the evening. Nice way to wake up, I guess, you know, doing stuff like this. How are you? How's your world? How's everything in the shrimp guild world? Oh, there was when is synth on this? I think there were just early signups. I might have snoozed on that one. Got him, fucking. I've got a cable that keeps going out. If I jiggle it, it comes back, but yeah. I see what we're doing. Thank you. totally exciting up there. How you guys doing? I don't know if you can see, but in the background I got this SpongeBob TV. It's an old TV. Magazine. A lot of things had magazines at the time, you know? The power. Nickelodeon was, that was kind of Nickelodeon when Nickelodeon was gross, huh? That's a noise. That's for Michael Vick ended up going to jail for something pretty bad. Thank you. I believe he's a sports guy. I don't know. I don't actually know who Vigelbeck is. Not a celebrity that's very relevant to me. Football player. There you go. See, not the kind of guy I would know anything about. Yeah, isn't that weird? Fucked up shit with animals. Like, I went to the sanctuary one time. It was like the lions, tigers, and bears sanctuary. Here's out near San Diego. It was like rescued like big animals, you know, lions, tigers, and bears. Stuff like that. But they were rescued from like people who had like tried to have them as pets. Yeah. Like rich people that like want to get their daughter a fucking animal and go exotic the Tiger King guy because I'm not joking, they had the Tiger King guy's animals there. Is that better? Great. Let me change my some of the bears there were rescued from a place where it was like a place where they would like place where they would like take bears and then they would like have them fight and they would place bets. Like they would like have bears and they would throw food in the middle and watch them fight and they would place bets and that was like what they did. And so that was fucked up. And so this place like, you know, had a couple bears that had been rescued from places like that. Yeah, it's really, like, upsetting. Like, upsetting to hear that, like, that exists. Yeah. And the thing that they were saying is that, you know, sometimes people want to have these kind of animals as pets. But these are wild animals. These are not like domesticated at all. And they will absolutely kill you. You know what I mean? It's like not a matter of if at that point. They're too strong, they're too big, you can't overpower them. They might not even be trying to kill you. You know? Yeah, they are. Let's get, you know, my cat here, she's not gonna kill me. I think it'd be cool to have a tiger or something, and then they try to get them from these. They don't know how to take care of them. They keep them in cages that aren't, like, suitable for their environment. And then the inevitable thing happens, you know? rough. Yeah, our cats would, kill us, but you know. Like, people just think it's like, it's like some sort of high class thing. It makes them look like they're rich or something. What I'm saying is, regardless of, you know, the origin of domestication and stuff, your dog, your cat at home, you can predict a certain kind of behavior, and you can't, and some people get those animals thinking they're gonna behave in a similar way to their regular cats. And that's what I mean. You know what I'm saying? Like and they are very much not. Like a cat that's lived with people for a while, like animals that have lived with people for a while are gonna behave very differently than animals that have not. And those kinds of animals don't really get to that point. There was a jaguar that they had, and like this woman had pretty much taken care of this jaguar since he was a baby. She was a good person. They had found it. She wasn't like wasn't abusive. It was, you know what I mean? And they were able to have like a human pet companion relationship for a little while, but eventually they had to separate. Obviously, like, she couldn't see her jaguar friend anymore, because like the jaguar had grown too much, and there's like no way the jaguar will kill you, you know, whether it's trying to or not. And so, like, the sanctuary, they have they don't, like, feed them with their hands. They have, like, a big stick where they'll take some meat and they'll put it in a stick, and then they'll put it, like, into them so that they can feed them from a distance. Fun watching them eat. But they said that jaguar, they would occasionally sometimes bring coffee and sprinkle coffee around her area. And it would get, it would be happy. Like, it remembered the smell of coffee, because, her mom, you know, the lady that it was close to for a long time, would drink coffee in the morning when she would hang out with it. So, it remembered her. But she still can't, like, hang out with it, even if it does remember her and love her, like, it'll still kill her. Yeah, that's the thing. That's the thing. Is like animals like that. They. I think I've seen the video you're talking about. I like bears. Bears are cool looking. Yeah, it was like a running bit on the Colbert Report that he was afraid of bears. Thank you. Yeah, I bet it'd be scary. Bears fucking love fucking... Turns out. Thank you. I wish I could pet a bear. Sometimes I call my cat Big Bear, because she kind of looks like a big bear. Oops. I don't know how much I love a more consistent melody, that's for sure. Little Oh, yes, brother. I'll be right. How we doing? Have you guys seen the new Spielberg movie, by the way? Movie that's like about his life and stuff. I thought it was one of the, my favorite, it might be my favorite Spielberg movie. Or at least one of my favorites. It's called, The Fablemans. I thought it was maybe one of the most heartfelt, most, like, thoughtful things I've seen Spielberg do in a long time. It was a really, really, a lot of times in movies, when people have affairs, or when there are breakups or complications in relationships, a lot of times movies will kind of, really oversimplify those things and make them very black and white, and this movie did not. It made everything very, very, like, it gave things the complications that they needed to explain, to talk about some of the situations that happened in his life. I thought it was a really, really good movie. It's about himself. He made a biopic about himself. I only go to the movies unless someone makes me, you know, so I don't really see a lot of stuff these days. Yeah, I'll be up there. Not really sure what my plans are, but I've got a couple things I need to do. I need to go to the city for a few things. First castle on the 19th? No. Probably not gonna happen. Don't hold your breath. Say that. Not that I'm inherently against the idea, but I already know I'm not gonna have time to do something like that. Oh. I think I'm only working 2 days a week right now, but I've got to spend this time preparing for a couple things because next year my life might go in a very different direction. I've got to kind of tie up some loose ends, so I've got busy. What is in Hearst Castle? Thank you. I would like to do a road trip someday. Maybe someday. I want to see every state in the U.S. That's the first thing on my list, is I want to see all 50 states. I want to see all 50 states, and then I want to go on a... specifically World War II tour of Europe. World War I and II. I want to see... I really would like to see, like, memorials, museums, grave sites, battlefields, you know what I mean? I really would like to, it'd be cool to, like, visit sites, but do it kind of in order, almost, of the war. I think that would be, or some of those wars, I don't know. I think that would be very interesting to me. I don't know, I want to do some traveling with some educational purposes. My dad just went to Vietnam and saw a lot of the memorial stuff over there. Yeah, sounds like those tanks just lying around. Sounds like that's what the front lines are getting. I see. Well, also sounds like that's what people at the front lines are getting. I don't know if you've heard much about the disorganization of their current military, but, I don't know if you've seen the video of the one general and they're talking, or not general, but the one leader talking to a bunch of soldiers. And they're like, you have to go buy your own medical supplies, basically, before you go off to the Ukraine. And they're like, well, we can't, all the stores are out of them. And then they're like, well, what you can do is you can go and you can get some feminine products, you can get some tampons, and if you get shot, you can use those to plug the bullet wounds. Like, damn, dude, you guys are in trouble. I like how you're like, you don't like doing something. Do you want to do the thing you don't like? Not really. I don't like, hey, you want to go get a hotel? Fuck yeah, let's do it. You want to do some glamping? You want to get an RV? Yeah, let's do it. I would like to see the Grand Canyon sometime. I've never seen it before, and I hear it's like breathtaking. I hear it's like actually very. Pueblos, New Mexico. There's cool shit in New Mexico. But you have to like weird stuff. You have to be weird like me. And like seeing random nothing. You know? I like the way this sounds a lot. Sample and hold, though. Sample and hold thing. I'm not sure what that would... I have to do some testing for that. Fun. It's a nice way to start my day. And by, you know, it's been a good morning, but by good morning, I mean I woke up at 1 p.m. because I live a weird life. You know what? You know what? Maybe I will camp. Maybe we will camp in the... Maybe we will camp in... The Grand Canyon. Do you camp near the Grand Canyon? Like, where do you camp? I've got to find a way. If I'm gonna ever camp again, I need to find a way to be more comfortable than where I have in the past. Oh, is Mikey still streaming? We might raid my buddy Mikey. Yosemite. One thing at a time. Took some pulling teeth to get me to Vegas for a wedding, you know what I'm saying? Alright. I'm gonna head out. I'll see you guys next time.